In this example, we're going to cover regression in Dr. B's Psych 200 Statistics course using the Nolan and Heinzen Statistics for the Behavioral Sciences six-step procedure to analyze if values are predictors of criterion variables. So we have a silly example for this one. So if I have data from several versions of the NFL draft, is there a relationship between a rival score and the predicted draft round? So rival score is where they give a person a sort of rating on how good they are. So higher scores are better. And draft round, obviously, or draft pick, not really round, is the lower the score, the better. Because if you want to be picked first, because that means you're the best. So can we predict, use those rival scores, right? So remember that X predicts Y. And this shouldn't really be round, it should be position. So can you use those scores to predict the position in which they'll get drafted? So 1, 2, 3, 4, that sort of thing. Okay, so we're gonna create a scatter plot with a regression line. We're gonna use the linear prediction rule to look at several different scores and talk about effect size and do the six steps. So here's the data. I have their score and their estimated draft position. Now, if you think about this variable for a second, it's actually ordinal, right? Because it's first, second, third, fourth. But what we've done is we've used it as a scale variable interval and measured across several years. That's why the numbers repeat. And then arrival score runs from 0 to, I think, 800. The numbers, the bigger, the better, either way. All right, so in SPSS, I created the scatter plot and added, so you may need to make sure that X is actually on the x-axis and Y is actually on the y-axis. And so it's a negative relationship, as you can tell, with the regression line. And so really, most of the dots are very close to the line. And we've got one extra kind of random dot out here. But what you see is that as they're goodness score, so arrival score is like how good you are, goes up, the draft pick position goes down, which makes sense because the higher your score, the better rated you are, the faster you're going to go in the draft. Okay, so here's the regression equation right here. So 30.21 minus 0.04x. Okay, so that indicates there's a negative relationship between the variables. And so that's what I would write for the equation. So I got y equals 30.21 minus 0.04x. Okay, where x is my score and y is my position. Okay. Now, if I want to predict people's scores, what I do is fill them in. So I've got y equals 30.21 minus 0.04x. And the first question was, what would be the predicted round for someone with a score of 700? So I would fill in 700 here. If you do that math, a plug and chug, we would expect them to go in the second or third pick. Okay. All right. I do the same thing for the other question, which was, what would I expect someone, round would I expect someone to go if their score was only a 300? I would expect them to go in the 18th pick. Okay. That's probably not very accurate because there are lots and lots of guys who are at the top. This is the point of the draft, but you get the idea. Like, we're predicting when they're going to go based on their rival scores. Okay. Now, for effect size, after you actually run the regression in SPSS, so there's a separate video for that, I can look here at R squared. Is 90% of the variance. So that's how you know this is made up data, because that is insane. That's most of the variance because that score only goes up to 1. And so we're predicting 90% of when they're gonna go. That would make sports betting very easy, but unfortunately it's not that quite that easy. All right, so let's test and see if this is 90% of the variance is significantly better than chance, and gosh, I would hope so. But let's start with step one, which is the assumptions. Okay, so the first one is that the IV and the DV are at least scale. Well, I've kind of already told you that pick position is actually ordinal, right? You go first, second, third, fourth. So we're kind of like iffy on that one. So I would say the DV is actually not, and then the IV actually is. But we're trying to run this as regression. I just try to come up with a goofy example. So I'd say that they're half there. And so if that happens in a real research situation, you'd have to do a different type of regression because having a DV that's ordinal is not good. Second one is that they're normal. I don't remember how many people we got in this study. Let's see. It doesn't really tell me anywhere. I guess I'd have to count, but if you have at least 30 people, it'd be normal. So let's see. 1, 2, 3. So I think we have 20. So N is less than 30. So no. Okay. And then can we randomly select? Oh yeah. So we have all the data for this. It's presented to us online. And so we can look at previous drafts and rival scores, and that is data that's freely available. So I could randomly select. The next question is homoscedasticity. So I'm going to scroll back and look at my scatter plot here. And most of the dots are very close to the line, and then you have this one dude way out here, but we're not going to count off for just one person. And so I would say yes, because they're evenly spread across the line. And on that one, if you're not sure, just tell me why you said yes or no. Okay, so yes, I'm going to say yes, they're evenly spread. So step two is to talk about what you expect to happen in your study. So we're going to say that the rival score is going to predict the draft pick. And you can spell that out in words, but the little arrow means to predict. And so I'm going to say that beta is not zero. You can also use B. And then beta is zero. So we would expect beta to not be zero if they predicted and to be zero if it wasn't predictive. Here is beta. So for step three, we would list beta. Remember, that is the same thing as the correlation, so it only gets up to one in a simple linear regression where we only have one variable. So that's a really strong beta. That's a big score. Okay. And then here is our B value. So if you don't get the regression equation on the line, remember that this first one is A, 30.21. The second one is B, negative 0.04. So that's where we're getting the equation from. And filling in X. Step four is going to be N minus 2. So we've got degrees of freedom of 18. And we're going to use 0.05. I'm not sure it says on the problem, but we'll use 0.05 either way. I'm going to come down here to 18, go across to 0.05. It's plus N minus 2.10. Okay, so our cutoff score is 2.10. In step five, we're going to calculate actual t. So remember, this is the constant. I don't want to use that, so I'm going to use this number here. So negative 12.97 is my actual t. And then in step six, I'm going to see if that is further out. So remember our little race car. And it's trying to go across the finish line here. So we got 2.10, 2.10, squiggle, squiggle. Out here is reject. In here is fail, right? And we're way over here at negative 12.97. So we are definitely going to reject the null. So when I reject the null, what I'm saying is, yes, we can use this rival score to predict draft position because the B or beta value is significantly better than chance. So we are predicting better than a random guess. So that is the six steps of hypothesis testing for regression using the Nolan and Heinzen book.